As an initiative of July being considered as Sakuma Awareness Month around the world, I would like to take you through to an interesting journey of one Mr. Pradeep, who was in his mid-40s. He presented to us with a history of severe pain in his right hip, radiating between his thigh and also his leg for nearly 4 months of duration. The pain was so excruciating that he was unable to lie down flat on the bed, turn to the side, and even sleep well or take care of his basic daily activities, which was worsening as time went past by. So we did all the imaging, and our imaging test actually showed a big tumor arising from the right hemipelvis, with the ilium bone and part of the lower aspect of the pelvic bone. As you can see here, this was actually the cause for the compression of the sciatic nerve.
Last year, the month of May, I started developing right leg pain. I consulted an orthopedist who diagnosed me as having right sciatica pain. I underwent physical therapy and started taking pain medicines. But even after physical therapy, my pain was not subsiding. So my orthopedist suggested to go for an MRI of the pelvis, which indicated right osteochondrosarcoma of my hip. I was referred to Dr. Srimant in Manipal Hospital, and after biopsy and scans, Dr. Srimant recommended surgery as the best option for my treatment.
Further tests such as a biopsy, which is image guided by a CT assistant, and also a PET-CT scan indicated that he was suffering from a chondrosarcoma, which is actually a rare form of a bone cancer or a bone sarcoma. So subsequently, we discussed this scenario in the tumor board, where all surgical oncologists, medical oncologists, myself, and other allied specialties sit together and discuss the treatment outcome with a personalized approach for this individual. And with the current evidence of surgery being the mainstay of treatment in chondrosarcomas of the bone, we offered him the same solution. The challenge in this scenario was that the tumor was so big, and it was actually the size of a mini football, and this was literally compressing the space where the sciatic nerve comes out from the spinal cord and traverses through the posterior part of the hip and the thigh and the leg to supply to its areas. So myself and Dr. Shabir Zaveri, who is a senior surgical oncologist at Manipal Hospitals, worked as a team, and we excised the chondrosarcoma of the right hemipelvis with the aid of advanced intraoperative imaging and 3D modeling to make sure that we remove the right or the adequate amount of tumor, at the same time try to save as much as normal tissue, bone, and especially the sciatic nerve also as possible. We could even with a great support from our anesthetic team have a very less blood loss also during the surgery.
After 2 weeks of my diagnosis, I underwent right hemipelvectomy by Dr. Srimant, and under his care, I recuperated well. Now, after 6 months, with regular follow-up with Dr. Srimant and with physical therapy, I am absolutely doing fine now.
I would like to highlight a special point in the scenario is that individuals with such pelvic tumors tend to present a little bit later than other situations because of the inherent space available for the tumor to grow compared to tumor arising from the upper limbs or the lower limb skeletons, where they tend to having symptoms a little bit earlier, or they get identified earlier because of the swelling. So it's imperative that patients with unexplained cause of pain or swelling in such areas visit the doctor at the nearest facility at the earliest and try to find out what is the causative factor of the pain, and also help rule out such rare scenarios of bone cancers. It's very heartening to see that post removal, Mr. Pradeep is able to get back to his work, and he's just walking around like every other normal person, rid of his pain and rid of his tumor, both in the same setting.